across the shore in distant lands with dark stars overhead. The prince was fast asleep until a cat jumped on his bed.
"I found a secret garden,"
said the cat with much delight. Excitedly, they ran outside, explorers in the night. They walked through the golden garden gate.
"Look at the pretty trees."
They walked along the pretty pebble path.
"Look at the colorful flowers."
They walked past the fabulous flowing fountain.
"Look at the dancing water. Look, look, look."
But the prince didn't like the garden and started kicking down the trees. He dug up flowers, grabbed the hedges, and pulled off all the leaves. He ruined everything for fun. The cat watched on in fear.
"What a mistake I made,"
the cat cried out.
"I should never have brought him here."
Yeah.
When the rabbit came to visit, the prince said, "Time to play." But his big red eyes, they scared her, and she didn't want to stay. Quickly towards the exit, the tiny rabbit hopped. The prince ran right behind her and screamed, "She must be stopped." Through dark corridors he chased her, hop, 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 a relentless, futile flight, hop, 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 round and round inside the palace, in and out of space and sight, hop, hop, hop. The prince, he couldn't catch her. His heart was filled with wrath. The rabbit slipped right out the door and vanished down the path. The prince cried out, "I need new friends. More, now, another."
"I'll bring you some, don't worry now," replied his loving, caring mother.
throughout the palace. The moon shone bright outside. The wind, it blew and blew. Oh no! The curtains flew open wide. The little prince was in his bed and couldn't get to sleep. So he called out for his mother, "Please go and find my sheep." "I'm thirsty," said the prince. So the sheep fetched a drink. "I'm dirty," said the prince. So the sheep changed his clothes.
"I'm tired," said the prince.
"Let me count you. 1, 2, 3. "Just one more thing," said the prince, "before I drift to sleep." He opened up his big red eyes and turned to face the sheep. "Come join me in my dreams. Stay forever in my head." Obediently, the sheep stepped forth, its mind consumed by dread. Good night.
June 2nd, log 940. Painting travel continues to be the best way to journey between worlds. I must stay hidden from the child, or I risk the same fate as the others. It's hard not to worry about being followed back, though. Best not to dwell on it. Okay. September 14th, log 821. Plant life continues to grow out of control since Newt's disappearance. Research heavily impacted. Frustration building. Feeling. January 22nd, log 285. My dolls have confirmed apartment 10 as a new yellow site. The baby and his sitters so far remain unaware of my activities. Is it egotistical that I made the dolls look like myself? Maybe, but who's to judge? You? June 2nd, log 940. Painting travel continues to be the best way to journey between worlds. I must stay hidden from the child, or I risk the same fate as the others. It's hard not to worry about being followed back, though. Best not to dwell on it. Thank you. July 28th, log 985. Half the building's ceiling caved in last night. The worst part isn't even the fear of being caught.
Thank you. Phoenix bots in.
February 27th, log 895. The cat. Well, she's a particularly curious creature. Whether she has motives or a master of sorts, I simply do not know. She appears intelligent and is quick to warn me.
Thank you.
August 15th, log 633. I woke with the incredible idea to redecorate. With no one else around, why not make the place my own? And I have this burning desire to paint the walls yellow. Yellow. So vivid and cute, and really such a fun word to say. Yellow. 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 This is the yellow room. Yellow, 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 yellow. Log ending. Soon to be yellowly. 27th, Lock 800. The cat. Well, she's a particularly curious creature. Whether she...
Thank you.
Why did you bring him here? What have you done?